I'm Martin from Cycle Streets. We're a social enterprise that basically runs a journey planner for bikes, so kind of plan routes mostly, and we're used by people like City Mapper and bikes and so on in London. One of the things that we created a while ago is a collision map, which basically plots the location of every road, reported road collision in the UK. So I've made a couple of sort of quick improvements over the last day, and this is more of an incremental little thing. And I can't actually show you the difference, but one of the problems with collisions is that they're collected by the police on an OS grid reference. And an OS grid reference is only you can only have it sort of within, it's basically like an actual grid, it's not like a latitude, which is much more exact. So one of the problems is that you get highly collision prone junctions like this one here, and all of the collisions end up in the same point. So the thing I've been doing, which unfortunately has just stopped working, is that it basically sort of breaks out the collisions all in one area by random maps. You actually now see all of them rather than just the ones that sort of all close on each other. So maybe if I can get it working, I'll try to show people. But basically, you can imagine this, and it just spreads out a bit, and then it's much more accurate. The other thing I've been working on a slight improvement for is we've been working on a project called Cyberscape, which is basically a toolkit for campaign groups. And the idea is that basically people kind of land on the map, some sort of problem. So here, this person happens to be me, says, you know, there's a problem with the way test case I'm lighting there. This is Zedrin K, and he says, you know, these are better walking and cycling routes in this area. And basically the idea is that, you know, people can draw on the map where there's a problem, and it becomes like a discussion. So rather than sort of an email list where you can get everything, it's a kind of, it's localized community email list for each thing. But and the idea really is that when you register to use the site, you can say, well, I'm interested in stuff in this area, or my route to work, or stuff around here. And so the idea is that if someone comes along and says, I'm concerned about something here, and that means that all the people who sort of subscribe to that area will be subscribed. But if say someone comes along and says, there's a problem here, I won't be subscribed by default. So it's sort of kind of like a geographical place matching. And one of the things that we've worked on recently is the problem of planning applications, because in the city we have huge numbers of planning applications and they're very, very difficult to track. And what often happens is that right at the last minute you discover, when you read in the Cambridge Evening News, that in 2 days' time the planning committee are going to be discussing some planning application that you think, oh damn, I wish I'd made 6 months ago. And planning applications, scrutinising them, are a big thing that cycle campaign groups like Cambridge Cycling Campaign do. And this is what they currently have to deal with. It's basically a dreadful council system, I'm afraid, sorry for the noise. So if I set to a Mill Road, which has got lots of developments on, after about 5 seconds, you actually get a result. Too many results. So there happens to be a map, but it's pretty difficult to use. It feels like it was sort of written about 10 years ago. And it's basically, this system is not designed for reuse of information. There's no raw data. If, for example, you're a cycle campaign group that wants to get a route alongside the railway, and you want to make sure that no new developments service that route, it's very difficult to deal with this because you have to work out every single postcode, you have to log in every week and so on. So we've been collaborating with a guy who's extracting, basically going around all the planning council planning websites and extracting them into a database, scraping. So the United for this had a feed, and we're the first user of this who is basically taking that information and actually plotting on a map automatically. And again, this is the list here of the planning applications ordered by the date they come in. In the areas that I'm interested in. So one of the things I've been working to, which I'm quite well working, is that unfortunately it also picks up things like tree changes or minor condition changes. So I've been working on things to just filter those out so that we actually get sort of actual real planning applications. And so the idea is that if, say, there's a planning application of interest to you, I don't know if there's something looks like it might be relevant to cycling, perhaps, you know, it's going to create more traffic nearby or at least for cycle parking, you can click convert to an issue and it basically fills that in. And then if I submit that, that's an issue like any other that people are discussing. So in theory, within a day or two of it being lodged on the planning system, there can be a discussion meeting where it's impossible to hear it. So a couple of very minor things I've been sort of trying to get in today and yesterday, but mainly been networking, which I thought was actually very useful. So anyway, so that's what I'm working on. Cheers.
Cool. That's brilliant. Thank you.